Hi guys, and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel, where it is all about Amazon KDP, building passive income streams and living a life of financial freedom. In today's video, I want to show you how you have to fill up the 7 keyword boxes when you're creating a book for Amazon KDP. The first thing I want to show you where you find these boxes and how to fill in these boxes with the keywords. The next step is what Amazon recommends how to fill in keywords in these boxes. And after this, a quick explanation what the recommendation of Amazon means to us. And after this, I want to show you how you can research the most relevant keywords for your book or your niche. I will show you 2 free tools you can use and 2 paid tools you can use and generate so a huge list with relevant keywords. So if you haven't done yet, hit the subscribe button, leave a thumbs up on this video. All the tools are in the video description down below. So have fun with this video and we will see us in 5.5 seconds, my friend. So the first thing is, especially for beginners who didn't publish the book yet, because all of you who have published a book already know where to find these 7 keyword boxes. If you are creating a book, for example, an ebook or a paperback, and you click on create paperback, you can scroll down and find these 7 keyword boxes. So you have to fill in keywords that are the most relevant keywords for your book or your niche. And with this 7 keyword slots, you are showing the Amazon algorithm that your book is relevant for these keywords. So this is the first big point. Make sure to only use keywords that are really relevant to your book. I will show you common mistakes in a few minutes, so make sure to watch the whole video so you don't make these mistakes. If you are in this section of creating your book, you have a little explanation of Amazon. You can go to this little sentence here, and as you can see, Amazon recommends to use the best keywords that are not in your title, category, or description and are already used to help readers find your book. So if we have a closer look on the help desk of Amazon KDP, I will link this page down in the video description. So the first thing you can see is how to add and update keywords. It is the same thing I already showed you. If you're creating your book, you find the 7 keyword boxes. And important to know, you can change the keywords in these boxes at any time. The next big thing is the best practice. So Amazon recommends to keep an eye on the character limit in the text field. The character limit at each box is 50 characters. So make sure you use as much characters as possible, but don't mix different keywords together that are not relevant for your book. The next important thing is this sentence here. Think like a reader. Imagine how you would search if you were a customer. This is a very big and common mistake what self-publishers do. For this video, we have the example of a composition notebook. Okay, and you are creating a composition notebook for girls. So think like a reader or a customer. A customer is browsing through Amazon and searching for a composition notebook for girls. Of course, another keyword is composition notebook for boys. So a common mistake what people do is they're typing in composition notebook and then they want to target all the different audience to get a good ranking on the book. So they're typing in girls, boys, kids, children. This is a really common mistake what self-publishers do. Have a closer look. You are a customer. And keep in mind that the Amazon algorithm is really clever. The customer is looking for a composition notebook for boys. You have the composition notebook for boys as a keyword in your box and your book appears to the customer. But your book is a composition notebook for girls. So what the customer is doing, your book appears, he sees the title, it's a composition notebook for girls, but he's searching for composition notebook for boys. So the customer ignores your book. This is a negative for the Amazon algorithm because the customer is browsing for your keyword. Your book appears for the keyword, but the customer is not clicking on the book. It's a negative point for the Amazon algorithm. So what Amazon does, Amazon ranks your book further down the list. On page 2, 3, 4, nobody sees your book, you're not making sales. So keep in mind, focusing on the main audience, what your book is targeting, okay? So use the most relevant keywords in these boxes. The next important thing is keywords to avoid. For example, don't use phrases like on sale, new, available now, best book ever, bestseller, because customers typing in best-selling book, your book appears, but what is your book about? So best-selling is way too broad keywords, so make really specific keywords in these boxes. Now we know what Amazon recommends. What does that mean for us self-publishers? As I mentioned, use keywords that are the most relevant for your book or your niche. Don't use this example targeting, for example, girls, boys, kids, children. Focus on one specific niche and one specific keyword, because all the keywords you're typing in that are not relevant, the Amazon algorithm sees it as a negative and will rank your book down the list. Okay, so always keep this in mind. So now the most important thing, how you can get the most relevant keywords for your book. As I mentioned, I will show you 2 free tools you can use and 2 paid tools you can use. We are starting with the free tools. First tool you can use is, of course, Amazon itself. You have to choose the category books, and then you are starting your research and have a closer look on the Amazon recommendations in the search bar. So we are typing in composition. So as you can see, Amazon recommends us keywords like composition notebook, composition college ruled, white ruled for girls, whatsoever. Now we have the example of a composition notebook for girls college ruled. So 2 keywords you can use in your backend boxes are, for example, composition notebook college ruled, and in the second box, composition notebook for girls. Okay. Don't use, for example, this phrase composition notebook wide ruled. So I would recommend to you, you're searching in the search bar of Amazon directly for different types of keywords like composition notebook, wide ruled, whatsoever. And then you make a list with the most relevant keywords that are describing your book correctly. And so you make a huge list with all the important keywords. The next tool is called Sonar. It's a free tool where you can type in different keyword phrases, or you can use the ASINs of your competitors and have a closer look on the keywords that the competitor book is ranking for. First thing, for example, you are typing in composition and click on ping. Then this tool will generate you keywords that are important for your main phrase. You can download it directly as a list and then delete all the keywords that are not relevant to your book. If you want to have a closer look on your competitors, you are typing in the main phrase in the search bar and then, for example, click on this book. Make sure to only use books that are at least 1 year old. For example, you can use this composition notebook, have a click on this book and scroll down to the product details. And then you can use the ISBN or the ASIN number, copy it and paste it into Sonar. After this 2 free tools, I will show you now 8 tools you can use. First tool is PublisherRocket, of course. I always recommend this tool because the first thing, it's very cheap. It's a one-time payment of $97. As you can see, you will never pay again. All the updates, all new features are directly in this price included. So it's a one-time payment and you will never have to pay again. The next good thing is you have a 30-day money back guarantee. So if you're not satisfied with the product, you can get your money back. If you have PublisherRocket, you can make a keyword research. it's the same process as, for example, in Sonar. You are typing in your main phrase, for example, composition notebook. And then PublisherRocket gives you all the Amazon suggestions for this keyword. So, for example, marble composition notebook, primary composition notebook, whatsoever. And then you can click on this button to have a closer look. And as you can see, it's a paid tool because it gives you information round about the average monthly earnings, the searches per month, the competitive score, and really good information about this keyword. For example, the primary composition notebook, search volume almost 6,000 per month, average monthly earnings 1,700, but a competitive score of 100. So very competitive keyword. What you can do, you can generate this list of keywords and have a closer look of the most relevant keywords to your book. And if you have a huge list with relevant keywords, use the keywords with the most searches per month and the most average monthly earnings. So for example, you can use Sonar, the Amazon search bar, PublisherRocket. And the last tool is Helium 10. Helium 10 is a little bit expensive, but I have good news. I have an affiliate link for Helium 10. As you can see, if you use MK Publishing 50, you can start your first month with 50% off. I would always recommend to use this code because what you can do, you can type in MK Publishing 50 as your code, get 50% off the first month, and then you can pause the subscription directly and use all the features of Helium 10 and only pay half the price. If you want to use Helium 10 over a longer time, you can use MK Publishing 10. So you get 10% off every month if you want to. Of course, there's a link in the video description. Make sure to check it out. So if you have Helium 10, you can use different tools. For example, you can use the Magnet. It's a keyword research tool. Or you can use Cerebro. It's a reverse product lookup. So you can copy and paste the ASIN or ISBN number in this tool and have a close look on the competitors, on the keywords of the competitors, and choose the most relevant for you. If you want to have a overall keyword research, you can use Magnet. Choose your marketplace, Amazon.com, typing in composition notebook, and search for this keyword. As you can see, Helium 10 will generate you a huge list of keywords with, as you can see, almost 5,100 keywords. So this is way too much. You can use different filters. For example, you want to use keywords that have a minimum search volume of 10. And as you can see, there are 2,300 keywords left. And you only want to target keywords that has the phrase composition in it. So as you can see, there are 694 keywords left. You can download the list directly into Excel or another file format. And then same procedure, make sure to only choose the most relevant keywords for your book and your niche. Now you have a very huge list of different keywords. You can use the search bar, Sonar, PublisherRocket, and Helium 10. Delete all the unimportant keywords that are not describing your book correctly. And then you have the most relevant keywords for your book and these keywords you are typing in your 7 backend boxes. The last thing, what I have to say, there are different types of YouTube videos out there. And people recommend not to use the same keyword or phrase in different boxes. So for example, there are typing in composition notebook girls. Then they say, okay, we already used composition notebooks, so we delete it in the second box. So college ruled remains. This is a common mistake self-publishers make because now you are targeting college ruled. College ruled is way too broad. It's the customer is searching for college ruled and you don't know what he's looking for. So in each box, make sure you describe your book correctly. So don't be afraid to use the same keywords in a different phrase in a different box. Now we are at the end of the video. I hope the information in this video helped you to fill in the 7 keyword boxes correctly. If you liked the video, make sure to hit the subscribe button and leave a thumbs up on this video. If you have any questions, please let me know down below in the comment section. As I mentioned, all the tools are linked in the video description, so make sure to check it out. Wish you all the best, and we will see you in the next video.